Okay, well, we're back, and King Brady wants to talk to us about Wednesday. Now, Wednesday is out on Netflix. Was it, well, you know, the other week or whatever?
Yeah, so, last Wednesday on. So, not there.
Fucking Wednesday.
A Wednesday series on a Wednesday.
Yeah. Is it all of it's out, not just a fucking trip?
All of it's out, yeah. All the episodes.
Now, I'll let you just take the lead.
So, Wednesday, as you know, Tim Burton was involved, so you're going to probably feel like it's Tim Burton. So
I
maybe
know he was involved. That's good.
So you might think a bit of darkness. Well, there was a bit of sprinkles of darkness in it, but Wednesday starts off where Wednesday's in high school.
Mm.
So from there, her brother Pugsy is getting bullied.
Mm.
And so
is he chubby in it?
A little bit chubby.
Yeah, that's why I want my Pugsy chubby.
Absolutely. But actually, his last Pugsy, have you ever seen Modern Family?
Yeah.
Another one, April.
Which one's that? Nerd?
The Nerd, that's actually Pugsley, the old Pugsley's
sister
in real life.
Okay,
But apparently they're in a dispute, so we won't get into that their dispute or whatever. But new Pugsley, but he was getting bullied, getting thrown into lockers on Wednesday Morris. So it's natural not moving face. You know, when this happening, you're gonna be bullied forever, and so she takes revenge on her own hands.
Mm.
So the Peel team is bullying Pugsley, and basically, she throws piranhas into pills, and apparently one of them loses a nut.
Oh shit!
So
that's not good.
Absolutely, we don't get to see the nut losing. But
I'm assuming it's a kid.
I think it's probably a late teen, maybe.
Still technically minor.
Minor, yeah.
Yeah.
But then I'll tell you what, later, maybe it might be a bit more. But I'll lead into it. Before she gets expelled from her school, we find out Wednesday can see the future.
And that was never a thing.
Yeah, never.
Family, no.
No, not in the first movies. No, I think in her thing, Wednesday was more of an up and coming psychopath. If you get me,
serial killer in the making.
Know what I mean?
Making a murderer and all that.
Making a murderer, like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And what you call it? But we find that out, and then as she gets expelled, we get to see actually her man, Dad. Was it Matrice Adams and Gomez Adams, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And well, I wasn't a big fan of the new Mel Adams, Gomez Adam.
Well, the Gomez, he's your man. He's in loads of films. He's hilarious. I don't know if he's funny in that. Mm. Is he funny in it?
He was all right, but he wasn't the first Gomez. What's his name? I can't think of the. He was in the 99 Adams families.
Yeah, I know. Not only guy what he looks like, but I don't know.
I can't think of his name, but like he wasn't like that.
Still refuse to accept my godhood. Keep your own god. In fact, this might be a good time to pray to him. For I beheld Satan and he fell from heaven like lightning.
But I say fair play to them. Like the ugly bastard gets to kiss a cat and treat his own in the scene. So happy days. Like,
yeah, fair play to him.
I'm sure
he's kissed plenty of gorgeous women. He's a funny fucker.
I know, yeah.
He's in have you seen Waiting?
I haven't seen Waiting, though.
Waiting, that's fucking gas. You should give that a watch. Really funny movie. Ryan Reynolds is in it. They have another one, Still Waiting. I can't really remember that, to be honest. It's not the original, it's just a remake. I don't think they had the original cast in it.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Forget Still Waiting, but Waiting, good show, good watch. So obviously you're managing loads of good films.
Absolutely.
But what was he like?
I felt like, I said there, he wasn't as good as the other one. So I think he was a bit of a letdown. I think he might have been missing his cast, because I know, Wednesday is now Mexican or the center or whatever. So I think they might have cast him saying, "Oh, he's an actor. He's same sense." So we'll cast him in it.
Mm. And Gomez is more of a Hispanic name, isn't it?
Yeah, Hispanic name. Mm. Yeah. So Gomez. So I think Morris, he probably won the role.
Yeah.
So it's because he was fast and panic, but I can't say the name proper Spanish or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then what do you call it? And then we had to see Lurch. I don't know. Lurch didn't really have much. You know.
No, he didn't much.
No, not much. He was just driving. That was it, really. So Lurch kind of fell out.
Was the hand in it?
The hand was in it.
Fester. Uncle Fester. The molester.
Yeah, Uncle Fester will be in later episodes.
Okay. Yeah.
So what do you call it? Well. So there,
that was your man who played the original one. Was your man from Back to the Future, wasn't it?
Back to the Future, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
But apparently, yeah, this one, the new guy who plays, I think it's Bill something. That apparently, he does a better job than your man. Apparently.
Yeah, well, like it wasn't like the best of acting for the original.
I know. Yeah.
I think everybody kind of knew who he was,
yeah.
And then kind of enjoyed the awkwardness of his character. But he punched above his weight in that film, didn't he? But everyone was just using him, wasn't he?
Yeah, using him. I think sorry, in the films are a bit confusing. Like, what was it? I think what one name he disappeared for a while. I think he disappeared and he was someone's mummy or something. And one of that, the next one he gets married or something. The story was a little bit confusing. That I mean, but what you call it? So. He comes in later season, so we won't get him for really one episode. But we're sitting there Wednesday, gets moved to Noma, a place called Nevermore.
Mm.
And we find out the rulers aren't really like these people, because these people are all superpowered. Some people are werewolves, some people are vampires, some people are sirens. Mm. So it's
sirens. What the fuck's a siren?
Fish people wear
fish people. Yeah. Right, well, that's called kind of Halloweeny, and that's kind of that's where their universe is kind of that,
yeah,
kind of style. But wasn't like superhero rather than just
not superhero.
I'd say mutants.
Yeah, kind of like mutants. Yeah. It's kind of like a place for all the mutants. It's like,
yeah, a sanctuary for all them, like Hotel Transylvania kind of thing.
Yeah, kind of like that. Yeah. But then all times I got a little bit of a Harry Potter feel off it, and then a little bit of Umbrella feel off it.
Was there a bit of wizardry going on?
A little bit of witchery, I think there was, like...
spells and potions, kind of?
Not really, but, like, there was... I put it after that feel, like, you know what I mean? Like, you know, the first one, there was, like, a race there, got on the first one, where they have to do a race. I felt like they weren't really where they're doing the Quidditch Cup thing.
Yeah.
So I felt like there was a bit of a Harry Potter elements, and then what do you call it? As I said there, with the violence earlier, like, there was a scene there, Wednesday bumped into another person, and she got a visit of him crashing the car. And we see your man's actual neck get broken in half. So it kind of pulled you there, where it's like more or less, all right, this might be a bit more violent than usual.
Mm.
And I think whilst there, we find out it also turns into a bit of a murder mystery, because apparently there's, I can't think of the monster's name, but I think it's called Demogorgon or whatever.
A Demogorgon?
Not a Demogorgon, sorry. It's a jackal. Apparently,
a jackal, yeah.
People turn themselves into jackals, and apparently they were expelled because they're too violent. So apparently there's a jackal going around and killing people and everything.
What age is this? Is this like 12 plus? Or is
I think it must be 12 plus, I don't know.
I'd say so. If someone nook got bitten off by a fucking piranha, then...
We don't see it, but like it's applied, so...
Yeah, yeah.
So that's the thing. So it's very, very, a bit more violence is uptake, but not as much. Like, yeah. It's not like the violence from like some other horror stuff you've seen, but it's...
Yeah.
But it's brought up, you know what I mean? Yeah.
What would you give it out of 10?
I'll give it probably a 7. I think
7's not bad.
I think it's
decent. It's worth the watch?
Worth the watch, yeah. Like, there was a few problems with it, but I think it was a decent watch, and hopefully...
Is there going to be a second season?
Well, people are watching it, and apparently it got most views, so I reckon they might be watched. So, that's the way it goes.
Okay, grand. Well, I think we'll wrap it up there.
I think we'll wrap it up there, yeah.
Yeah, Phoenix Hustle out.
Phoenix Hustle out.